All right, well, let's play first. I'm down with it. There's that Ashen Rider again. We're only two market festivals away. We could turn three Stone Shocker Giant and just start clocking. I don't know how that works. We could turn four Cyclops. Is just making a giant monster going to be effective? Is that the winning play against another green red deck? Could be. I think it's probably going to be pretty hard to kill. As we see a faded conflagration, which we're also very far away from casting. Yeah, our deck doesn't operate very well without drawing four lands and playing a market festival, I think. Which is, I th think, wow, that's annoying. I think is a tier one strategy. Wow. It's like Chameleon Colossus, but with counters. I should have played the other mountain next last turn, but whatevs. Fives. Sure, I'll just play a fatty. Like, the Hedonist is irrelevant because of this Wayfinder anyways. Nice play by the opponent. I bet the opponent drafted, say, your Wayfinder highly just for this situation. Okay, hoping for Market Festival off the top next turn, and then we can start dropping bombs. I have three of the card. Stop hiding from me, Sigiled Starfish. I need you in my life right now. Okay, well. Yeah, I'm thinking about GP Manchester is coming up for me. Spearpoint Oled. Okay, well. Hey! We're only one Market Festival or Voyaging Seder away from casting Ashen Rider. Pretty good. Pretty good. Oh my god, faded conflagration is going to be huge. Gotta play around Mortals Reserve, but I'd say that this is pretty good. I think so personally. Yeah, so I mean I want the Voyaging Seder not draw. Still, the turn two Seder, turn three Festival. Turn four, Twiddle, untap, Ashen Rider. Turn four, Ashen Rider. This deck can do it. Es posible. No. Es necesario. Okay, so this is interesting. I like attacking and keeping up mana to cast Faded Conflagration in combat, potentially. Since it's our turn, we're gonna scry. 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we could also cast Cyclops of the Eternal Fury, but I'm not huge on that right now. Now, I'm expecting the opponent has two tricks potentially, and this might not go that well for us. Okay, so far so good. If it just eats it to a burn spell, that's be fine. Coordinated assault. Oh, if the opponent has like the immortal whatever, the thing that gives it indestructible, this is actually gonna work out pretty nicely for him. So, well, it's gonna work out okay. I'd say pretty nicely. Like, maybe not getting a 2 for 2 trade of two really, yeah. 2 for 2 trade of two of rares, basically rares and uncommons. Oh, it's gonna happen. 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 We're doing it. So yeah, that was pretty nice by the opponent. I walked right into it. definitely walked right into it. Could have not attacked and passed the turn, and or could have faded conflagration first to get an idea. Yeah, that was probably the play. Play it and then save the giant. I don't know. It's hard to say. The Satyr Rambler is likely to trade with the Satyr Wayfinder. The Wayfinder is pawning us for faux show. Voyaging Satyr, your turn. Nothing to see here. 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 I'm flooded. Oh no. Don't kill the Satyr, bro. It's not a threat to you. It's not a threat to you. Also play something better. So we can kill it. We could wait. We could wait. I kind of want to wait for the opponent to play something better, and we can play the Fleet Feather Cockatrice as well. I don't know why the opponent didn't attack with the Oread. That's pretty weird. It's pretty weird. Alright, I'll stop it with the Larry David. Maybe go into some George Costanza shtick. Okay. We'll pay the tribute. And then Ashen Riders is gonna hob it. Chromanticore is about to be in play. Man, this is gonna be epic. Wow, that's a good draw too. Black, white. It's like, you gotta be kidding me. Yeah, that just happened, bro. Welcome to my mind. Alright, send. We're doing it. We're gonna make it through round one, guys. The Rambler's gotta come out. I haven't seen anything that it interacts well with. We'll just jam in some more swamps and plains. I don't know. See if we have anything else expensive we can throw in. Just assume we draw Festival Satyr every game. Yeah, the Cockatrice I had to pick. Just look at the art. It's just a great forehead tattoo, I think. I don't know. I've been thinking about, like, some kind of MTG tattoo. So we'll see if I pull the trigger on that. But I feel like it'd be pretty hard for me to regret, even if I'm not playing the game when I'm older, which is unlikely. Having played for, 20 years now, when it really has put me on and been my career, let me do all these cool things. It'd be pretty hard for me to imagine regretting making, some kind of even foolish permanence. Just a thought, just something to think about. Yeah, like a green mana symbol on my nose, Bright, bright green. Sick. Something light, no colors. Y'all would probably never hear about it. Except unless you likely see me post some kind of selfie on Instagram, It's more realistic. 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm just gonna monstrous this. Could play Bolt or Cyclops. Either way, man. I like to think the opponent had that Magma Jet the entire time and is like, what's the worst thing that could happen moment? Okay, Bolt of Kronos is likely to be able to finish this job. Yeah, what's the worst thing that could happen? Okay, back to game 3. This Rambler needs to go. Hedonist is fine because the ability was decent there. Do you have anything else like expensive? Not in green or red. I haven't really seen too much to kill, but if we can scry two, it's just awesome. So I'm gonna leave that in. Let's look at potentially playing some kind of a blue card. Vortex Elemental, not very good against the rare, but pretty nice. Pretty nice effect, I think. Yeah, I'm down to try it. Stick with the one island. Ooh, opponent's sideboarding as well. Or don't have a good read as to whether they're using the bathroom or not, but it's exciting to think that there's some leveling and re-leveling going on. It's like maybe he boarded out his cards that were good against Seder Rambler in anticipation of us boarding out Seder Rambler. Woo!